Hello. In this video, we will focus on source-free series RLC network. So far we discussed source-free parallel RLC. Now we will see source-free series RLC circuit. Okay. So circuit will be in the parallel RLC case, resistor, capacitor and inductor all are in parallel, but here all are in series. You can see here resistance, capacitance and inductance with current direction, if you take like this I passing through the all components, that is I, and voltage across capacitance is VC. Okay, and voltage across inductance VL. Okay. Now if we write the KVL for this, this will be I into R plus voltage across the capacitor. So voltage across the capacitor, it is 1 by C into T naught to T and I dt or dt dash also you can take dt dash plus VC of T naught. So voltage across capacitor, how to calculate that? You have to integrate current passing through it from the interval T naught to T, and you have to add the initial voltage VC of T0. This you refer our video on capacitors, there I have explained this, the current and voltage relationship between voltage relationship of a capacitor. Okay, just you refer that video. Okay, so then plus voltage across the inductor. So voltage across the inductor is L di by dt, that equal to zero. So this equation, if you differentiate with respect to T, then what you get is, I will write first L d square I by dt square plus R into di by dt plus 1 by C into I. So this equation you compare with parallel RLC. So parallel RLC, what we got? We got actually C d square VC or V divided by dt square plus 1 by R dV by dt plus 1 by L V equal to 0. So this is what we got for parallel RLC. This is parallel RLC. And this we are getting for series RLC. So you can see that the form is same with the change in the coefficient only changes. Otherwise, all the this equation form is same. So solution also will have the same format. So what is the solution? The same method you have to follow. You just refer video on parallel RLC. So initially we assumed a solution V of t equal to an exponent, and then we substituted, then we finally we derived the output form is nothing but in this V of t, sorry, in the parallel RLC it is V of t into A1 e power S1 t plus A2 e power S2 t. This is what we obtained for parallel RLC. Now in this series RLC here, you will get in terms of I here. So I of t equal to A1 e power S1 t plus A2 e power S2 t. And with S1 and S2, S1 and S2 having the value, there is a little change here only here. In the parallel RLC, it is minus 1 by 2 RC. 1 by 2 RC, but here it will be minus R by 2 L plus or minus square root of R by 2 L whole square minus 1 by LC. So here there is a change. So in the parallel RLC, this term was 1 by minus 1 by 2 RC. Here R is at the numerator. That is the only change here. So alpha value in this case, in the series RLC, alpha value will be R by 2L. There it was 1 by 2 RC. Here it is R by 2L. And omega naught is same, that is square 1 by square root of LC. There is no change in that. So alpha value is R by 2L, that is the only change, and omega naught is 1 by root LC. Now comparing this alpha, depending on the value of alpha and omega naught, we can have different responses. That is, first one, if alpha is greater than omega naught, then the response is called overdamped. Response is called overdamped, and I of t will be of this form, that is a1 e power s1 t plus a2 e power s2 t. But if alpha is equal to omega naught, then it is a repeated root. We will call the response is nothing but critically damped. Critically damped. So then I of t will have this form, e of minus alpha t into a1 of t plus a2. This is for repeated roots. Okay. And third one, if alpha is less than omega naught, then the response is called underdamped. Underdamped. And I of t will have this form then, e power minus alpha t into b1 cos omega dt plus b2 sin omega dt, where omega d is nothing but omega naught square minus alpha square under the square root. So that is the only change here. Okay. So while analyzing circuit, what we have to see is, first we have to see whether it is a parallel RLC or series RLC. For that, what you have to do is, you have to deactivate the independent source and see whether RLC are in series or are they in parallel. Then you have to apply this formula. If it is parallel, it is alpha equal to 1 by 2 RC. If it is a series, it is R by 2L. Alpha equal to R by 2L. Omega naught is same. Okay. So, as an example, we will solve one simple form, a simple problem, then we'll go for the complicated one. So question is, determine I of t if I of 0 is 2 milliampere and Vc of 0 is 2 volt. So circuit is given here. This is 18 kilo ohm and this is 1 microfarad and this one is 9 Henry. And voltage across this is Vc and current passing through inductor is I, and we will take voltage across inductor is VL, like this. Okay. So initial current and initial voltage are given, so you no need to calculate that one. So it is series RLC, so we will go for step 1. So step 1, if you go, you have to first find alpha. Alpha is R by 2L. So if you substitute R and L value, R is 18 kilo ohm and 2 into L, it is 9. So it is 1K or 1000 per second you will get. Next, you calculate omega naught, it is 1 by root LC. So it is 1 by L is 9, capacitance is 10 power minus 6 under the square root. So this will be 3 into 10 power minus 3. So if you take the numerator, 1000 by 3, that is 333.33 radian per second. that is omega naught. Now compare alpha and omega naught. Alpha is greater than omega naught, so it is overdamped response. Overdamped response. So you can easily calculate now S1 and S2. So what is the S1 and S2? Here also I have to mention that what is S1 and S2. I can write like this: S1 and S2 is minus alpha plus or minus alpha square minus omega naught square. So that if you substitute here, overdamped response, S1 is minus alpha plus alpha square minus omega naught square. If you do that, you just try that, you will get value minus 57.19 per second. Okay, just you verify that. And S2 is minus alpha minus alpha square minus omega naught square. So in that case you will get minus 1942.81 per second. Okay, you just see that value whether it is correct. But you mainly concentrate on the procedure rather than the values. You see the how you have to solve the problem. First you have to find alpha and omega naught. Then you see compare alpha and omega naught and find out S1 and S2. So after that, next step, step 2 will be the initial condition, but it's already given, no need to calculate that. So one step we can skip here. So step 2 here, directly we can write the response. What is the response they asked? I of t. So I of t here, since it is overdamped, it will be a1 e power s1t plus a2 e power s2t. Okay, so how to calculate this one? I know I of 0 plus, it is already given in the problem. I of 0 plus is 2 milliampere, it is given. So that is 2 milli, and you substitute t equal to 0, then you will get a1 plus a2. So we have one expression here, we have one expression. And second expression we need. So how to calculate? We know I of t. If you calculate di by dt and you equate to t equal to 0, what we will get? We will get VL of 0 by L. Just see here, voltage across inductance is nothing but L into di by dt. So yeah, di by dt, and you substitute t equal to 0 in that. So that is equal to VL of 0 plus, this should be 0 plus, VL of 0 plus by L you will get. Okay, so how to know this VL of 0 plus? We know VC of 0 plus, so from that we can calculate VL of 0 plus. Okay, so here in this one I will rewrite that circuit. So this is capacitor and inductor, and you have I flowing through like this, and this one is VC and this one is VL, and it is 18k. So if you apply the, I want to find VL of 0 plus. So if you apply the KVL here, 18k into I, 18k into I of what here? I am finding here at 0 plus, at this instant of time I am calculating. So everywhere I have to consider that. So I of 0 plus, that we know, I of 0 plus, we know that. So that one plus VC of 0 plus, that also we know, that is given in the problem, plus VL of 0 minus 0 plus, that should be 0. This is known, 18k, I of 0 plus known, I of 0 plus is 2 milli, plus VC of 0 plus is given, that is 2 volt, that is given 2 volt, and plus VL of 0 plus we have to calculate now. So from here it is straightforward, VL of 0 plus equal to 18k into 2 milli, that is 18 into 2, the 36 plus 2, 38, so minus 38 volt, that is VL of 0 plus. Okay, so in this equation, di by dt t equal to 0, I of t is given here, this is I of t, that is nothing but a1 s1 plus a2 s2. If you substitute t equal to 0, then you will get this a1 s1 plus a2 s2, isn't it? So if you a1 into e power s1 to into s1, but t if you are substituting 0, then it will be a1 s1, similarly a2 s2. Yes, so that is equal to, you have to write this part now. What is that? VL of 0 plus, just now we calculated, by L. L is 9. Okay, so we know S1, we know S2, so you will get another expression in terms of A1, A2. We have already one expression containing A1, A2. You will get one more expression A1 and A2. So then if you are using this simultaneous equation, you will get value for A1 and A2. You solve that and find out these values. Once you know that, then you substitute in the main equation. So I of t is equal to this a1, whatever value you calculate that you put here, into e power minus s1. S1 we had calculated, that is 57.19 t, plus you write whatever a2 you calculate you put here, and e power minus 1942.81 t. You will get this response. Okay.